Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the vlog. I have to head out in literally 20 minutes, but I want to have at least these 20 minutes to myself in the quiet of the morning while enjoying my breakfast, which is this delicious looking overnight oats. All right, let me enjoy this and then we'll get ready and head out. If you're new here, I'm Grace, a 30-year-old living somewhere in the New York City area, and I make these videos to capture raw stages of my life and states of mind.
So good.
I won't burden you with the details just yet. We have this whole vlog to get to know each other. So come spend these next few days with me.
It's gonna be a long day.
Okay, let me catch you guys up. I do need to commute at some point today, but before that, I have a morning dentist appointment. So I said in my last vlog that I was going to see the dentist to get my general oral examination for the year, and I distinctly remember saying, I hope they don't deliver bad news. But guess what? They did deliver bad news, and it's not just your normal cavity situation. More information about me. I grind slash clench my teeth pretty severely in my sleep. It's been happening since I was young, according to my parents, and I've been wearing a mouth guard for the past several years, pretty diligently too. But apparently that has its limitations because, according to my orthodontist, I have something that's called vertical bone loss, which I'll try to explain it the way I understood it. It took me a while. It's basically, there's a bone inside your gums that holds onto your teeth, but one of those bones has reduced in size, essentially, because of the clenching. And so she's referred me to a periodontist, so that's where I'm going to get his opinion and consultation on what I need to do about these bones. Is it a coincidence that all of these problems, these health problems, are surfacing in the year that I turn 30? I think not.
Not dressed properly, so my mouth is frozen. So I'm stopping home again to wear a jacket and then head back out. So much time wasted today, but I'm sure I'll thank myself later.
I have decided not to go into the office today because I only have a few more hours until I have to head out for dinner because I have dinner plans with a couple of my girlfriends. So I don't want to lose any more time commuting. So I'm just going to work from home today. I'll probably go into the office tomorrow since I do need to go in one more day to meet the 3-day mandate that my company has set. Anyways, update on the periodontist appointment. He told me all of these issues weren't super serious issues, which made me feel a lot better. Unlike the general dentist who freaked me out by telling me she was very, very concerned about the health of my teeth and my gums. I do need to extract my wisdom teeth or wisdom tooth, just one, because it has cavities. That's next week. All of this is on me for not being as proactive as I should have about these checkups, but better late than never, right?
All right, we are headed into New York City now. Boy, am I glad I changed. Do you see how windy it is? Hopefully, this mic does its job.
We're home. Gosh, it has been a day. I feel like the bulk of the day was just me walking, going from place to place. I'm not complaining about the walking, you know how much I love it. It's just, it was so windy and cold today. My friend showed me this funny reel during dinner that basically said New York City has 12 seasons. What we had experienced for the past couple of weeks when it was super warm and nice was deceptive summer. And now currently we're in third winter. It's pretty funny. Anyway, the restaurant we went to was not good. Do not recommend. My friend and I had both found it on TikTok and Instagram. The reel that we saw made it look really fancy and really nice. It's supposed to be this Korean fusion restaurant. But when we checked it out, there was like one other person there besides us. It was completely empty and the food was not great. I mean, like, it didn't taste that bad. If I weren't paying for it, I mean, I would gladly eat it. It was okay, but very unremarkable. And it was definitely not Korean at all. Just not very differentiated. I feel like there's so many Asian fusion restaurants in New York City. It goes to show you shouldn't believe all the recommendations that you see online on social media, because everyone can make a reel look good. You gotta go to the places your friends recommend. It's like 10 p.m. I got up really early this morning because of the dentist appointment, so I'll probably go to bed pretty soon. Plan to be horizontal for the rest of the evening because I've been using my legs too much and they need rest. But 'twas a good day. It was nice to see my friends again. One of them recently came back from Taiwan. She's from Taiwan and she usually goes there for several months. Actually, I told you about her before. Her name's Christine. She has her own YouTube channel. Yeah, she was in Taiwan for 3 months and she came back and she was telling us about working in Taiwan on New York hours, just like I did in Korea, but only briefly compared to her. I don't know if I'd be able to sustain that schedule for 3 months straight. So she's such a trooper. Anyway, she's back and we were talking about doing like a collab soon and planning out all of these content ideas for the rest of the year. It's nice to have a friend who also does YouTube because I can freely talk about stuff like that with her and we can be more creative together. And these days work hasn't been super fulfilling for me, so I feel like I'm leaning more heavily on YouTube for that sense of reward. Okay, I keep yawning every 5 seconds, so I'm gonna go to bed. Good night.
Hi. It's 5 p.m. Just got off work. Going to the gym. Put all your stuff away and check out for the day. There's no time to waste when it's 100 degrees. Burns under my feet. Won't you have a drink with me? To shower and get ready because we're meeting with some friends and going to eat dinner in Fort Lee again. Another K barbecue place we're exploring. There's a party in the streets and the city's on fire. Decided to just wear a t-shirt and something thick on top rather than layer up because we're gonna be grilling barbecue and I don't want the smell of the meat to get into all my layers.
Now we're gonna head to Uga. I found this place on Instagram. They don't take reservations, so we're expecting a little bit of a wait since it is a little before 7 p.m. so it should be peak time now, but hopefully we can get in because I've heard good things.
They said it's gonna be over an hour wait. So we're gonna try our luck because this place is popping.
Oh, literally.
evening now already. I haven't checked in all day because it's been really uneventful. It's just raining the entire day, so we just chilled at home. I edited my video pretty much the entire day, got some chores done, you know the drill. Now actually we're inviting a few friends over to our apartment to have a little cute movie night. We'll probably order in pizza or wings or something like that, and maybe have like a few homemade cocktails. My boyfriend really loves making cocktails, so he's the designated mixologist tonight. If you are wondering why my usual voiceover ramblings haven't taken place yet in this vlog, the truth is, I've been feeling a bit cynical towards myself and these quote-unquote introspective monologues of mine. I'm conscious that there's just so much content out there in the world, and adding to that is really the last thing I want to do. My workaround so far has been to tell myself, even if my life is the same as everyone else's on the internet, I'll try to differentiate by documenting the thoughts that make me, me. But then the other day I thought, who am I kidding? What's so special about what I've got to say? It's not that deep. It's not philosophical. They're average thoughts of an average 30-year-old. So I guess I want to ask, to those of you watching and listening, whoever you are, why do you watch these vlogs? Does anything I say ever make sense? I'm genuinely curious. Anyway, that's what's going on in my mind at the moment. Thanks for bearing with me and watching this unflattering footage of me gorging on a bunch of greasy takeout. And I know no one asked, but yes, I have gained a bit of weight due to some stress eating in the past few days, and I don't want to talk about it.
Actually a little too sweet. I should have put just half a banana. That combined with the protein powder is making it a little sweet, but the texture is perfect. Very creamy. This is what I plan to eat when I get my wisdom tooth extracted tomorrow.
Yep, you heard that right, friends. Tomorrow's the day I get the tooth removed. It's not my first wisdom tooth extraction, so I know more or less what to expect, but then again, my previous surgery was 10 years ago and the tooth wasn't as impacted as the current one, so I imagine it'll be a little different this time. Yeah, it's gonna be a fun next few days.
Hello, it's around 5:30 p.m. I just finished my workout and showered, clearly. Remember that guy I mentioned in my last vlog that was making these animalistic grunts in the gym? He's back in the gym again today. Between sets, he sings too, so actually pretty entertaining. Okay, I need to quickly get ready and head into the city because I'm getting dinner with a girlfriend. This is kind of an impromptu meetup. My friend's kind of going through some personal stuff at the moment. Obviously, I can't really talk about that because it's not, you know, my story to tell. So tonight is all about just me showing up for her and being a good listener, being there for moral support, just being whoever she needs me to be. I am glad that tonight worked out though for the both of us because, like I said, tomorrow I'm getting a wisdom tooth pulled and we'll likely be immobile for the next foreseeable future. So glad we can make tonight work. All right, let's get ready.
Christopher Street. Yeah, I think Carrie's probably gonna take it. Oh.
Hello. We are back in Jersey. It's around 11 p.m. I did take tomorrow off, though. I'm not too worried about getting home and going to bed too late on a weekday. It was a really, really nice time with my friend. We obviously talked about what she was going through, but also a bunch of other things. Things we could both relate to as people in our early 30s, which I feel like is a time where you realize more than ever the level of effort and sacrifice that anything valuable in life requires of you, but also the need to balance that with your own mental, physical, emotional health and self-worth. Also, I wasn't originally planning on taking photos or clips. I was worried it would be a bit insensitive because I'm there to be a moral support for my friend, not to capture content, but my friend actually went ahead and was taking photos and posting on Instagram and stuff, so I kind of took cues from her. So I did manage to get a few clips, which is why that's there. To be fair though, I do think she was trying to act a bit more strong and stoic in front of me and not really show the level of, you know, fragility that maybe she was experiencing inside, which I totally get. I'm the same way. I hate appearing weak in front of other people and getting too emotional. And I'm sure like she also needs her own time to process her feelings and kind of let the feelings sink in. All in all, I'm really glad I was able to have this heart-to-heart with her. I think this was just another instance that proved that you really don't know what people have going on in their lives and what people are dealing with and what's going on behind closed doors. So all the more reason you shouldn't compare yourself to other people or hold yourself to external standards. This isn't me trying to instill life lessons on anyone. It's more me just repeating things that I'm constantly trying to remind myself of because I'm very prone to judging myself based on what I see other people doing and what they've achieved in their lives. So it's something I constantly have to remind myself of. But yeah, I think at the end of the day, everyone's just walking a pretty lonely path that they can't really talk about with a lot of people. Yeah, those are my fragmented thoughts. I now need to make my way home and prep all the smoothies I need to drink for the next few days while I am short of one wisdom tooth.
All right, folks, we're home. I just washed off all my makeup. I'm probably gonna watch some TV and then go to bed. My surgery is at 11 a.m. tomorrow morning, so I think I'll make a separate vlog on that, just documenting the whole process. I don't know how interesting that'll be, but that's its own separate vlog. I'm gonna end off this one here. Thanks so much for watching, as always. Hope you enjoyed. Hope there was something you took away from it, whether it was some feeling of comfort or relatability, or whether it was just, I don't know. I hope it was of some value to you. Anyway, I will be back soon, sans one wisdom tooth, and I will see you then. Thanks for watching.